Now, Yasin, you're obviously a high-risk, low-reward fighter because, people just aren't giving you the opportunity. But, I mean, there's some guys out there who are not as big as the names as you'd want. I mean, have you tried getting in contact with anyone like Ryan Rhodes or Prince Aaron?
Well, these people, I faced them ages ago. Ages ago. Actually, 2008, 2009, I was trying to fight against Ryan Rhodes before Ryan Rhodes fought against the Mexican rubbish fighters. Everyone is ranking him that he's the best in the
Exactly,
world.
Saul Alvarez, right. Yeah,
Yeah,
which
Alvarez, yes. And listen, this Alvarez, yes, everyone is talking about him. He fought against Ryan Rhodes, stopped Ryan Rhodes, fought against Natalie Hatton. Come on, hang on a second. There's someone who's better than these guys. Here in England, you know what I mean? Based in England is me, but you don't want to give me a chance against him or against these guys.
Yeah, I mean, your style, you're a very awkward fighter. You'd give, in my opinion, like, listen, I'm a believer of styles make fights. Do you agree with me on that?
No, I am 100% agree with
Now,
you.
your style, you've got a very awkward style, and you'd give anyone trouble. Whether you win or lose,
Yeah.
personally, I think you would beat Alvarez. People will be listening to this, calling me crazy because of how he's ranked. And to be fair, he is very good, but when he comes up in a style against your type of fighter.
Well, let me tell you something. I swear to God, anytime I watch this guy, I know he's a basic boxer. He's a basic boxer, which he's 20 or 21 years old. He's got 40 fights. That means this person, he's been pushed from the beginning. He got people, he's got money behind him. He's got golden boots. He's got a lot of money behind him. He's a Mexican. He want to bring another Mexican on the table. They let him fight against the not good fighters. They're ranking. They're giving the WBC fight. Oh man, I can't talk about this guy, man. I just get upset, man. I just get really upset because I know that this guy, I would beat him. And we don't have to go so far, yeah. If I tell you this one, yeah, because I'm chasing this guy and he doesn't want to fight me. He doesn't want to fight me. He doesn't want to even jump in the ring with me. He doesn't want to even have a conversation with me. Kell Brook. Kell Brook will beat him. You know what I mean?
Exactly. I was gonna exactly mention him next, actually, because I've watched you. I can tell you want to fight him. I mean, I've even seen that video where you walk up to him and you start speaking to him, and him and Eddie Hearn, I think Barry or Eddie Hearn, and they just don't want any of it. They just
No, it's Eddie Hearn, it's his son. Listen, they don't want that to happen. You know what I mean? I was with Amir Khan about 2 days ago, and he was talking to me. It's funny that when he was chasing Kell Brook and this and that, I said, I don't know what Kell Brook want to go and fight you. He should go and face me first. Then if you want to fight you, you're right, Yasin. But I'll tell you something. That's Amir Khan is saying that. I'll tell you something, Yasin. That you awkward fight. I ain't gonna get near you, this guy. And Jimmy Ritter beats Kell Brook. You know what I mean? And how come Junior with this Kell Brook, he can't face me? They know that's a big risk for Kell Brook because Junior Ritter beat him, and I beat Junior Ritter. You know what I mean? And Junior Ritter throw himself from the ring, and they'd be frustrated, dropped him down in the first round. It looks a little bit. If we put a match against Kell Brook, he will look bad. That's what we don't want
I
to
mean.
happen. And it's not only the fight. It's not only I want to fight like to make money. I fight for free. I will pay to get this fight happen. I will give money. I will put
I
like
I
a
can
big
believe
purse.
that. I can believe that. Listen, I mean, I was looking at the ratings. You've heard of BoxRec.com, haven't you?
Yeah, of
Yeah.
course. Yeah, that's
Listen,
all the
you're
time.
this fact annoys me, right? You've beaten Junior Witter, right? And you also beat the other former world champion on the
On a
same night.
line.
Yeah, that's
Yeah,
exactly
then
right. Now,
two former world champions in one night. This will never
exactly,
happen in
exactly. That's
one
all
of
you need to know, really. I mean, you're rated 45 on the list, and he's rated Junior Witter, a guy who you've beaten, is rated 35, 10 spots higher than you. I mean, what's going on there?
Well, that's the ranking goes with the fights. Look at Junior Witter. Look at Junior Witter, how many fights he had after the first fight up.
It's a bit of
Look
politics
at
as well,
all
isn't
the
it?
And look how many people fought after the first fighter and haven't had a fight. I haven't fought once. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And if this fight, while I was fighting on an Ali Adams and Aldo Harrison show, if the fight was like a proper fight and someone was just there to see, listen, this guy's going to be tougher for a match or something like that, like what I did to Jimmy Colas, number 4 in Europe. I beat him for 10 rounds. 10 rounds was mine.
Mm-hmm.
If it was a person like that, I will forget about my knee and then go and fight. But because the fight was a lot of people texting me and Facebook saying to me, hang on, I say, yes, why you fighting this guy? He's not in your league. Why you want to take this fight? This guy is nothing, he's rubbish. People say, oh, I'm not going to come watch Yasin. We need to fight someone who's big, I will come. A lot of people writing like comments, fighting Ryan Toms. He's not a big name. You know what I mean? That's why I'd like put me in the time as well.
Listen, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to throw a few names at you, and I want you to tell me what you think of them. Right? Matthew Hatton.
Okay. Matthew Hatton, I will stop him. Probably I will stop him late rounds, 8, 9, 10.
Yeah. Frankie Gavin.
Frankie Gavin, I don't know him, to be honest with you. I never watched him.
Okay, fair enough. Devin Alexander.
Devin. From America?
Yeah, the American.
American. Devin Alexander, I would beat him. He's all day long.
I would love to see that fight. You know why? He beat Maidana in his last fight. Now he's Devin Alexander's a big name, and
he is.
Listen, I'll be honest. I don't think they're gonna give you an opportunity once again because you're too much of a high risk and low reward fighter. But Andreas Katonic, right? The one who fought Amir Khan.
Yeah.
He's Andreas Katonic, the one Khan fought to win the world championship.
Oh yeah.
The WBA. The I think he's Ukrainian guy.
I know him. He's not bad, but he's a cover. He's like a journey. He's a world class journeyman.
He's a very basic fighter, isn't he?
Yeah, he's like Clotty. Clotty is a world class journeyman.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You go to the top, then you become a journeyman.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. And now that guy, if many people say he got robbed against Alexander, right? And let's be honest, he's a fairly basic fighter, right? And if he can give a guy like that problems, why can't you? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, we all know that in boxing there is a lot of politics, you know?
Okay.
And politics will never gonna finish in boxing, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
But what I can say now, I'm a coach at the moment. I'm training people, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just renewed my license.
Yeah.
I renewed to fight on the 26th of May.
Okay.
Obviously, I'm not fighting because knee injury.
Yes.
But I'm training people. But if it's a big fight for me, I will do it. If it's a small fight for like a British title or something like that, I won't take the fight. Look, I beat two guys and prize fighter. But both they had the British title. Colin Lyons, he won the title. He lost against Junior Wittar. Junior Wittar beat him and prize fighter. You know what I mean? There was only 3 rounds. But if it was more than 3 rounds, it would be a whole different story and ring.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Kell Brook get beaten up by Junior Wittar. He's the best at the moment in the country as a welterweight.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Who else? That's only big names.
You don't have to tell me that, mate. I mean, listen, I can see you're clearly, I mean, there's something wrong here. I mean, you've seen Adil Anwar. You know about him, don't you?
He's the last prize fighter.
He's likely to fight for the British title. Audley Harrison, when he won the prize fight, he got a world title shot against David Haye. I mean, you see so many of these guys, when they win prize fight, they got opportunities. But you get the picture, don't you? Listen.
There is a lot of things against me. A lot of things.
Yeah.
The promoters that against me for no reason. I'm not doing nothing to them.
Let's just put it this way: you're a feared man, not just from other boxers, but from promoters. You're a nightmare to them as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So simple as that. Yeah, this is how it is. Yeah.
Listen, I'm running out of time, but before I let you go, I'm gonna get your thoughts on a few upcoming fights. We got David Haye versus Chisora coming up. What do you think of that?
No comments.
No comments?
Because no comments. We train the same gym. Dave Chisel and me, we've got the same trainer.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And we trained the same time. As I was in the gym today. He was there shaking hands with me, and it's gonna be a tough fight for the both of them.
Okay,
no
fair
comments.
Enough. Fair enough. Mm-hmm. Now Amir Khan versus Danny Garcia, that got announced just yesterday. What do you think of that?
Yeah, Amir Khan all day long.
Yeah,
he will be in points, or probably he will be late stoppages. He will stop him like late 10, 11, 12, or otherwise we'll go points.
Yeah. You've probably got this question loads of times, Mayweather Pacquiao, but I'm not going to ask you Mayweather Pacquiao. I'm going
to
ask you.
No, you can ask me because I love to answer this question.
I know who you think is going to win that because I've seen your interview. Yeah. You think Pacquiao, right?
Yes, and I know you think that Mayweather will win.
No, I actually agree with you. I was going to actually ask you now. I was going to ask you, who do you think would win out of Floyd Mayweather versus Sergio Martinez?
Oh my God. I will put money for this that Sergio Martinez will beat Mayweather.
You know what? I agree with you 100%.
And I will put money. Listen. You don't know that Sergio Martinez, he's the hell of a tough fighter?
Listen. Yeah. He reminds me of you. He reminds me of you. The way
he fights. Yeah, it is. And he's a sneaky fighter. It's hard to hit him. His hard touching.
He's very slippy, he's awkward, and he turned pro. I don't know if he had any amateur experience, but he turned pro at 20 years old.
Same as me.
listen, he got given the opportunity. I hope you do as well. I really hope you get these big fights, mate, because I honestly think you can do something in the world scene. And listen, it was a pleasure talking to you. I appreciate
thank
for
you so much.
You take your time out and listen. I hope you have fast recovery and good luck for whenever your next fight is, man.
Thank you so much, Buff. Nice to speak to you.
Listen,
and keep in touch for all the fans. Thanks a lot for watching boxing, watching me, or supporting me, guys. We're all boxing, obviously. Thank you so much for your interview.
Hope to speak to you soon, mate. Take care.
This is Yassine, man.
That was Yassine Omachi.